In 2017, Snowy 2.0 was announced as a bold plan.
The Snowy upgrade.
Snowy 2.0.
Snowy 2.0 project.
Snowy Hydro 2.0.
A $2 billion Australian clean energy mega battery that would transform Australia's renewable future. The idea was simple yet ambitious. Store excess renewable power and deliver it back to the grid when it was needed most. It promised to power millions of homes, stabilize the nation's electricity supply, and cement Australia's place as a leader in clean energy innovation. But today, that dream looks very different. The budget has blown out to a staggering $12 billion Australian. The schedule has slipped by years, and mounting challenges have raised serious doubts about whether the project can deliver on its promise. What began as a visionary leap forward has now become one of the most controversial energy projects in Australian history. The question is no longer how it will succeed, but whether it can succeed at all. To understand why Snowy 2.0 matters so much, you have to go back to the original Snowy Mountains scheme, completed in 1974. Built across some of the harshest terrain in the country, it was one of Australia's greatest engineering achievements. The project involved 16 major dams, 8 power stations, and more than 140 kilometers of tunnels, carved deep into the mountains of New South Wales. It didn't just generate electricity, it transformed agriculture by diverting water to some of the country's driest farmland. For decades, the Snowy scheme powered homes, fueled industries, and symbolized what Australian engineering could achieve. Snowy 2.0 was conceived to build on that legacy, a modern counterpart designed to tackle the challenges of a renewable energy future and replace the coal plants that still dominate the nation's grid. Snowy 2.0 is essentially a giant underground battery hidden beneath the mountains. Instead of storing energy in lithium cells or chemical batteries, it uses something far simpler – water. The system relies on 2 massive reservoirs at different elevations – Tantangara, high in the mountains, and Talbingo, far below. These are connected by 27 kilometers of tunnels, drilled through solid rock. When renewable energy like wind and solar produces more power than the grid needs, huge pumps push water uphill from Talbingo to Tantangara. When demand spikes, that same water is released, rushing back downhill through powerful turbines to generate electricity. At full capacity, Snowy 2.0 will deliver 2,200 megawatts of dispatchable power, enough to supply 3 million homes. Its storage capacity is enormous, capable of running at full output for almost a week. That's 350,000 megawatt hours of stored energy, the equivalent of several coal-fired power plants operating non-stop. On paper, it's an elegant solution, a renewable battery built on a scale few other technologies can match. But building it has proven far from simple. When the project was first announced, it was expected to cost $2 to $3 billion and deliver its first power by 2024. It was marketed as a fast, relatively inexpensive way to secure Australia's clean energy transition. But those early estimates didn't hold for long. By 2018, costs had crept past $4 billion, and by 2020, they'd surged beyond $5 billion. Today, in 2025, the official budget has reached $12 billion, 6 times the original figure. The timeline has slipped just as dramatically. That initial target of first power by 2024 has been pushed back to late 2027, with full commercial operations unlikely to begin before December 2028. What was supposed to be a quick win has turned into one of the most delayed and expensive infrastructure projects in Australian history. Building Snowy 2.0 required drilling through some of the toughest and most unpredictable geology in the country. To do this, engineers deployed 3 massive tunnel boring machines, each the size of a commercial airliner. They were named Florence, Kirsten, and Lady Eileen Hudson. Florence was the first to begin tunneling in 2021, and almost immediately ran into trouble. Just a few hundred meters into her journey, Florence struck soft, unstable ground. The tunnel began collapsing around her, and in early 2022, a 9-meter-deep sinkhole opened up on the surface. The machine was trapped underground for more than a year as crews worked to stabilize the area and figure out a way forward. Finally, in late 2023, Florence was freed and tunneling resumed. But the delays didn't end there. Throughout 2024, progress remained painfully slow, with unexpected geological conditions making every meter a battle. To get back on track, a fourth tunnel boring machine was brought in to speed up excavation. Even so, the project still faces the daunting task of completing nearly 30 kilometers of underground tunnels through some of the hardest rock in Australia. As if the engineering wasn't difficult enough, Snowy 2.0 also faces major environmental challenges. Excavating millions of tons of rock has exposed acid-forming minerals and even traces of asbestos, creating serious concerns about safe disposal. If these materials contaminate nearby waterways, they could harm the very reservoirs the project relies on. The tunneling itself poses risks as well. It could lower the water table by up to 50 meters, potentially drying out alpine bogs and mountain streams that are vital to local ecosystems. All of this is taking place inside Kosciuszko National Park, one of Australia's most sensitive protected areas. Conservationists warn that the project could permanently alter fragile habitats and allow invasive species to spread through disturbed soil. The stakes couldn't be higher balancing renewable energy development with the preservation of one of the nation's most iconic landscapes. The difficulties aren't limited to the environment. Safety concerns for workers deep underground have also made headlines. In 2023, toxic gas leaks inside the tunnels forced emergency evacuations, underscoring the dangers of operating in such confined, hazardous conditions. While no fatalities occurred, the incident sparked a broader conversation about whether enough was being done to protect the crews driving the project forward. At the same time, public trust in Snowy 2.0 has begun to erode. Critics accuse the project's backers of downplaying setbacks and failing to communicate openly about delays and risks. With every cost increase and missed milestone, skepticism grows over whether this monumental effort is still the right path for Australia's energy future. When Snowy 2.0 was conceived, pumped hydro seemed like the ultimate answer to the challenge of storing renewable energy. It offered massive capacity and proven technology, on a scale no battery could match. But technology doesn't stand still. In just a few years, grid-scale batteries have advanced at lightning speed, dropping in cost while increasing in size and efficiency. These smaller, modular solutions can be built faster and closer to where the power is needed. As a result, some energy experts are now asking a difficult question. By the time Snowy 2.0 finally comes online, will it already be obsolete? Snowy 2.0 remains one of the most ambitious renewable energy projects in the world. It represents vision, ingenuity, and an attempt to solve one of the biggest challenges facing modern power grids. But it also embodies the risks of thinking too big, too soon. If it succeeds, it will stand as a defining achievement of Australia's clean energy transition, a modern counterpart to the legendary Snowy scheme of the past. If it fails, it could go down as one of the most expensive missteps in the nation's infrastructure history. For now, the mountains hold both the promise of a renewable future and the weight of a $12 billion Australian dollar gamble.